and welcome to the first Wes Miller Show of the 2017-2018 season, where I get the pleasure of sitting down with Coach every 2 weeks. So on Friday night, you and your team traveled to Charlottesville to play the Cavaliers. Just tell us a little bit about that experience.
Well, you know, we didn't like the result, but outside of that, it was a positive experience for our team. Thought we played with good effort. You know, I thought our guys really competed, and this time of the year, that's about as important as anything. I think our guys are really trying to do it right, and we saw some really good things out there. I liked the way we guarded in the first half. You know, we struggled to score, but, you know, you got to give Virginia credit. They're a great defensive team, and they made it difficult at times. And we also missed some shots that I think we'd like to have back, and so you got to be pleased a little bit with our offensive execution on possessions that got us great shots. We just weren't able to convert them. So, you know, some positive things to start the year, but, you know, we're so competitive, we always want the result with it as well, and we were disappointed we didn't get the result and thought we had some real opportunities, but something to build on for sure.
And then what do you think your team could take from playing such a good defensive team like Virginia?
A lot of the things that make their defense great are some of the things we value as well, and it's something we can learn from here early in the year. Hey, we're just as athletic. We have as much size as they do. You know, we're doing some really good things defensively, but we got to get our hands active like they have their hands active. We got to be as consistent as they are on a possession-to-possession basis. And I think our guys were able to see some of that on the film, and hopefully we can learn a little bit from that.
And your team out-rebounded them by a 36-30 margin. What can you say about winning that rebound battle?
Yeah, you know, Kelsey, it goes back to some of the effort plays I talked about. I did think we played with great effort, and I think you can always kind of get a gauge for effort on the backboards. But certainly, because we out-rebounded by six, that's something that we're proud of. I think we can be a terrific rebounding team. We want to be a terrific rebounding team on both sides of the ball. I think this team should be exceptional on the offensive glass. We got to be a better team defensive team, or team rebounding team on the defensive glass. But that was a good start to the boards for the season, and again, something we can build on.
And your team was down by 19 in the second half, but managed to trim that down to 8 points. What allowed that?
I did like our team's grit, our toughness, our ability to climb back in it and cut it to eight. I don't want to praise it too much because I think we expect that. I mean, these are guys, this is a team that's a veteran team in a lot of ways. They've been through a lot of Division I basketball games. We expect them to keep fighting. We expect them to be competitive. But it was nice to see that they got down 19 in a tough atmosphere, and they were able to climb back in it. All that said, it's an 8-point game with 7.5 minutes, and we turn it over on the next three possessions. And that was a little frustrating. And I don't think the turnovers were as much that they forced us to turn it over. I thought they were turnovers that were just mental errors on our part. So we really did have some chances when we got it to eight there, and we're going to watch that film again before we get through the week here to try to learn about how we can take advantage of situations a little bit better.
And what was it like seeing Kylia Sykes and Isaiah Miller on the court for a game for the first time?
Yeah, you know, it was great because you see a bunch of great athletes running around out there. You know, I think our team's just across the board getting more athletic year to year, getting more size and length, and I think those two represent that. You know, shoot, I might be taller than Isaiah Miller, but he's long. You know, he's a super athlete. But we're becoming a more athletic roster, and I think that's going to be conducive to the way we want to play defense and the way we want to get up and down the floor. But there's two freshmen right there that are going to have really solid years this year. I really believe that because of what they've shown us so far in practice. And it was nice for them to get some real game experience, and I think they're only going to get better and better.
And after game one, what would you say that you identified that you want to improve on for the rest of the season?
You got all day. Yeah, I don't think there's a coach that's in basketball right now at any level that's happy this time of year. I mean, there's, you know, I think if there wasn't a lot to improve on right now, then what would we be doing for the next 4 or 5 months, you know, because it really is about getting better each and every day. And we talk about the idea of growth each and every day here at UNCG, and we got to grow in every area. But as you know, if you want me to get specific here, and I'll specifically answer your questions, you know, I think we got to get a better focus in our preparation. You know, I thought we were really excited to play against Virginia. I thought our guys had great energy and wanted to compete in practice leading up to it. But our focus on the details and the things that it takes to win wasn't what I'd like to see. I'd like us to grow in that way in a really short period of time.
And then you have your home opener on Wednesday night against North Carolina Wesleyan. What's it going to be like for you guys playing in front of your home crowd for the first time this season?
Yeah, we're excited. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're real excited. I think we got a taste of playing in front of fans here at UNCG for Spartan Madness, but that's nothing like a real game. Mm-hmm. And so I think it'll be great to get out in front of our fans and our season ticket holders and play for the first time.
Thanks so much, Coach. That's all we got for today. Make sure you tune in to our next coaches' shows and stick around for some fall sports updates as they wrap up their seasons and head into conference championships.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you.
In Greensboro and Winston-Salem, it would be Jason Bramblett. He attracts hundreds of buyers and creates so much demand that Jason can guarantee if your home doesn't sell at a price and deadline you agree to, he will buy it.
Partner with the agent I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
With the 350 sub of the day at Subway, there's never been a better time to try something different. Because every day of the week, you can now get a featured 6-inch Subway sub for just $3.50. So mix up your lunchtime routine and treat yourself to the endless flavor combinations at Subway. The 350 sub of the day. We took an already great lineup and made it even better. A better price, great taste, and no artificial flavors. The 350 sub of the day, only at Subway.
All right, it's been a great few months of UNCG fall sports, and now their seasons are wrapping up, so it's time for a quick update. Cross country finished their season at the NCAA Southeast Regionals this weekend at Virginia. India Godluck, Madison Owings, and William Sandine all posted a personal best. After a 3-2 victory in the semifinals against Furman, men's soccer made their 11th championship appearance, playing against number 4 seed Mercer. Two overtime periods didn't seem enough, and after a hard fight, the Spartans fell to Mercer 3-2 on penalty kicks. Junior goalkeeper John Milligan, junior defender Josh Maston, and junior midfielder Matteo Busio were named to the all-tournament team for the Spartans. After a victory against the Citadel on Saturday, volleyball improves to 18-10 on the season and 11-5 in SoCon play for the fourth straight season. This senior class has combined to win 44 SoCon matches in their careers, which is more than any other class before it. They are entering the Southern Conference Tournament as a 3-seed and will play Chattanooga in the first round of the tournament on Friday. And as for women's soccer, they brought home the SoCon Championship title after defeating Western Carolina 1-0. The Spartans now have 8 tournament titles, which is the most for any team in the history of the SoCon Tournament, and this is the Spartans' first title since 2010. Reagan Lehman was named the SoCon Tournament's most outstanding player after leading the Spartans' defense in addition to her 1 assist on the game-winning goal. UNCG placed 4 on the all-tournament team, including Emily Jensen, Sienna Rideout, Reagan Lehman, and Haida Viedersdotter. The Spartans advanced to the NCAA tournament and after a hard fight, fell 1-0 to number 3 Duke in the first round. Good luck to the volleyball team as they head into the SoCon tournament, and congrats to all the rest of our fall sports for a great 2017 season. Make sure you tune in to the next Wes Miller Show in 2 weeks.